I'm talking about Cliven Bundy, who wonders if blacks are better off as slaves than on government assistance. No kidding. Mike Papantonio, America's lawyer, with us here on the Ed Schultz Radio Show. We thought he was a racist. Now we have confirmation. Thank you, Mike. Thanks for joining us. This Bundy story gets even more interesting with the support of Fox News host Sean Hannity.
You know, Ed, fools always rush in before they even understand the questions, much less the answers.
I want the media research in that nut job. What's his name? Who's that guy with the beard?
Brent Bozell. That's who I was trying to think of, too. Yeah.
Yeah. Get Hannity, get him on there and have him help you work out of this hole.
You know, the point to this, the most bothersome thing, Ed, is the fools who I'm talking about that need to focus on the Bundy story, the focus should be not just Bundy himself, but the low information, kind of analytically brain dead types who've been in front of cameras telling America what a noble patriotic hero this racist, white supremacist, deadbeat rancher is. You almost have to ask yourself whether the Rand Paul, Dean Heller, Sean Hannity types are dramatically challenged. Do they just don't get it? Not to be able to see this in 30 seconds, not to hear the facts, and in 30 seconds, notice that Bundy and these lunatic followers were the same kind of anti-government racist who all had the capacity to be America's next Timothy McVeigh.
So what does this say about Harry Reid's comments? Let me bring the audience right up to date. Now, keep in mind Senator Rand Paul, Kentucky, who wants to be president, Dean Heller, Republican from Nevada, where this is all unfolding, they have come out in staunch support of Cliven Bundy. And so has the Texas Attorney General Greg Abbott.
Mm-hmm.
They now are distancing themselves from this comment. Bundy has given an interview, and he says, I want to tell you one thing I know about the Negro. And because they were basically on government subsidy, so now what do? As he's quoted by the Times, they abort their young children. They put their young men in jail because they never learned how to pick cotton.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And I've often wondered, are they better off as slaves picking cotton and having a family life and doing things, or are they better off under government subsidy? They didn't get no more freedom. They got less freedom.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I mean,
you have to add, to me, the troubling thing is that either you say that Rand Paul and Dean Heller and Sean Hannity, that they simply have a lack of understanding in the world. And understand, these are people in positions of power. Or worse, did they immediately recognize that, yes, Bundy and his paranoid posse are racist, that they are clearly members of groups like Stormfront or the KKK, and they are dangerous. They're hate-driven racists who not only hate minorities but would gladly blow up another federal building with children in it, just like their martyr Tim McVeigh. My bet is that right below the surface, they do have that quality about them. They saw it. You know, Ed, the first night you covered this and you showed those films of the people, it looked like it was just chaos. It was their scream out for anarchy. Anybody that has any life experience at all could have understood what this group was, including Rand Paul, including Dean Heller and Sean Hannity. In 30 seconds, they could have understood exactly what Bundy was about. And so you have to conclude that, they were the lucky ones. Rand Paul, Dean Heller, Sean Hannity, maybe they were lucky because they're politicians, they're in positions of media personality. Otherwise, you have to conclude that it's just as likely that they'd be standing in that same cow pasture with those other conspiracy theory wing nuts holding an AK-47. Yeah. I mean, you almost have to conclude that.
I think a big part of the story, Mike Papantonio, America's lawyer with us here on the Ed Schultz Radio Show, a big part of this is how these people are emboldened by those who are in a position of visibility, i.e.
Mm-hmm.
Sean Hannity.
Mm-hmm.
Hannity, cut five of the big list, fellas. Hannity says he says if they come back, if he's talking about the Bureau of Land Management, listen to what he tells these guys on the air.
I'm glad at this point it has not ended in a catastrophe, but I fear, guys, this is not over. I would take Harry Reid's admonition warning seriously. And if I was scheduled to be out there tonight, if this didn't end this weekend, if they come back, I'll be out there with you. Thanks for being with us.
Okay, so Sean Hannity's going to stand with a lawbreaker, and he's going to stand with now a bona fide racist. Hannity supports these guys, and I'm not going to let him walk away from it until he apologizes and distances himself. These people are anarchists. They're anti-government. They are anti-American. They don't belong in America. They don't. They're not Americans. They don't want to live by the law.
Well,
a representative government. They want to defy it. And Hannity says he'll stand with them.
Now, this is sedition. I mean, there's no other way. Look, let's go back in history. 1987, you had 14 white supremacists indicted by the federal grand jury for much less than this was. Between 1983 and 1985, this 14 group of white supremacists did far less than what we saw, where they had AK-47s trained and aimed at federal agents. That's sedition. You have a case of Laura Byrne. This was a nurse of the U.S. Department of Veterans Affairs. She was charged with sedition, Ed, for simply writing a letter to the editor saying that things weren't working well in the Veterans Administration Hospital. So it's just a matter of what the government wants to do. They have plenty to work with. They have films of these people. I can promise you, Ed, I promise you, being a prosecutor, I haven't seen this before. There are more outstanding warrants in that group. They're everything from child support to God knows what. And so, they have them on film. Go get them.
Yeah.
Close them down.
Okay, so Rand Paul wants to be president. This is his level of judgment. He'll support this guy before he vets him, before he really knows what it's all about. Now he's got to backtrack from it. What if the president had pulled a stunt like this?
Exactly.
And the other thing is this. Let's not forget that Hannity has a real problem with character judgment. This is a guy who thought, who was nothing but a Bush bootlicker to the very end, that lied us into a war and killed Americans. This is a guy who defended George Zimmerman.
Mm-hmm.
And now this is a guy who says he's willing to go stand with a law-breaking racist if the BLM comes back. Wow.
Ed, this may be the last burnout. This is the same path that Ann Coulter took, that Michelle Malkin took. They're barely recognizable now. You only see them at CPAC. You don't even see these people anymore. This is the last burnout. This is him trying to hold on to this dead or dying, mentally and physically group of people that still think that he has something to offer. When you see this kind of desperation, it's the end of this guy's career. It is the end of his career, Ed.
Well, any fair-minded American is going to think he's a whack job. I mean, he is totally in denial of who this guy is and what this is all about. And he's caught himself in a situation. He's got too much of an ego to turn back and say, I was wrong.
Yeah, even management at Fox may say, it's time for you to go out to the cow pasture with these guys.
it's people like this that, gin up the emotion in all of these folks that think that they actually have a chance. They don't. Bundy is going to lose. He is not going to get away with owing the federal government $1 million. The world doesn't turn like that.
Well, the good thing about the way that this story has developed, Ed, if you think about it, the first couple of days, you were really one of the few people covering this story. But what's happened is it's allowed everybody. It's allowed the fools to commit themselves. It's kind of let's make somebody the king for the day. And then the king comes out and they say, my God, this person is a dolt. The judgment's terrible. That's what's happened with Sean Hannity and Rand Paul and Dean Heller.
You know when Hannity is defeated. You know he's defeated when he pulls out 5 and 6 year old tape of me. he plays tape of me from yesteryear, and yet when Jon Stewart does it, Hannity goes on the air and says, oh, this Jon Stewart, he's pulling out tape of me from 4 or 5 years ago. Hannity's doing that to me, the guy is such a loser.
You can bet Roger Ailes is having some soul searching today, and he has to say, okay, have we passed another era where we've become so crazy, so insane, that we have allowed this lunatic, Sean Hannity, to further discredit our network? That's what he's thinking about today.